Hello dear students, myself Ruchi Kaushik Sharma, assistant professor in department of mathematics, Babu Banarsidas, National Institute of Technology and Management, Lucknow. Today we will learn about some basics of matrix algebra. It is a very important tool in your BTech course, as well as it is essential for many competition examinations. For example, in GATE there are various questions in every year. So let's start with matrix algebra. So today we will learn about definition of matrix, types of matrix, matrix operations, real and complex matrix, and then some elementary operations. So the term matrix was apparently coined by Sylvester in 1850s, but was introduced by Cayley in 1860. So let's define matrix. It is an arrangement of numbers into rows and columns. Each row is the same length and each column is also of the same length. We can define M cross N matrix in this form. There are N rows and N M columns, no sorry, M rows and N columns. So this is first row, row 1, this is second row, row 2, and this is mth row. Similarly, we can see this is first column, this is second column, and this is nth column. So the first number shows number of rows and second number shows number of columns, and the notation A11 defined the A11 element is in the first row and first column. Similarly, we can see the element A21 is in the second row and first column, and we can see the element AMN is in the mth row and nth column. So we can take an example of matrix, like if I take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is first row, second row, third row, this is first column, second column, third column. So there are 3 rows and 3 columns. So the order of this matrix is 3 by 3. Now we can take the column and rows as vectors. I can write the column 1 is in the form 1, 3, 5. There is a column and 3 rows. So the order of this matrix will be 3 cross 1, and I will call it a one dimensional matrix. It can be a one row or one column. So it is called vector. We can treat it as a special case of matrix. So now I am coming to types of matrix. There are various type of matrices. First of all, identity matrix, row matrix, column matrix, null matrix or zero matrix, then square matrix, diagonal, scalar, symmetric, skew symmetric, triangular, then orthogonal, unitary, Hermitian, skew Hermitian, idempotent, periodic, nilpotent, and involutory matrices. There are various kind of matrices, and we will study all these matrix in detail. So, first of all, square matrix, a matrix in which the number of rows is equal to the number of columns. We can see in this case, if number of rows equal to number of columns, if m equal to n, then we will call it a square matrix. So here I have given an example. There are 3 rows and 3 columns. Now, row matrix, a matrix having only one row is known as a row matrix. We can see here the number of rows is only 1 and 3 columns. So, this matrix will be called as row matrix. Next, we have column matrix. In column matrix, there is only a one column. So, this will be called a column matrix. Then, null matrix. In null matrix, all the element of the matrix are 0 elements and the order of this matrix is also 3 by 3. There can be of 0 null matrix of any order. We can write it is in the form of m cross n or n cross n form. It is a null matrix of order n cross n. Now, diagonal matrix, a square matrix in which the diagonal entries are non-zero and all other non-diagonal entries are 0, then it will called a diagonal matrix. Now, scalar matrix, a diagonal matrix in which all the diagonal elements are equal to a constant or a scalar. Suppose it is k, so we can write it is in the form of this. This is a 3 by 3 scalar matrix. All the diagonal entries are equal and equal to k, which is a non-zero scalar quantity. So, now unit or identity matrix, it is a very important matrix. We write it I 3 by 3. If it is of order n by n, then we can write it as I n cross n. So, all the diagonal entries are equal and equal to 1. It is also a special case of scalar matrix where k equal to 1. In previous slide, we have defined scalar matrix. If we write k equal to 1, then this scalar matrix will be defined as identity matrix. So, now next is upper triangular matrix, a square matrix in which all the elements below the principal diagonal are 0 is called an upper triangular matrix. Here we can see if there is A, B, C, D, E, F, these are non-zero quantities and all other quantities are 0. So, the entries below principal diagonal are 0. It is called as upper triangular matrix. So, now lower triangular matrix, in the similar way, here the entries above the principal diagonal are 0 and all other entries are non-zero, then it is known as lower triangular matrix. We can see here triangle is formed in this manner. So, it is called lower triangular, and in previous case the triangle can be formed in this way. So, it is called upper triangular matrix, right. So, now I am coming to triangular matrix. A square matrix is said to be trigonal matrix if it is either lower triangular or upper triangular. Now, next is singular and non-singular matrix. A square matrix A is said to be singular if determinant of A is 0 and non-singular if determinant of A is non-zero. So, for checking singular matrix, we have to check, suppose we have a matrix in this form. Now, I want to check this is a singular or non-singular matrix. So, firstly, I have to write it is in the determinant form minus 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. It is equals to 1, then 0, minus 0, minus 0, and minus 1 into 0 is 0. So, it become so now we can see it is also a 0 minus 0, now plus 1, here it is also 0 minus 0 is equals to 0. In next slides, I will teach you about how to calculate determinant of a matrix. But here we can see the determinant of this matrix A, which is equals to 0. So, this matrix is a singular matrix. And as you studied in previous classes, if a row or column of a matrix is completely 0, then the value of determinant of that matrix will be 0 itself. So, we directly can say about this matrix that this is a singular matrix. So, now symmetric matrix, a square matrix is said to be symmetric if A equal to A transpose, that is by transpose we can define transpose of a matrix as, suppose I have A is in the form A B C D E F G H I, then the transpose of A will be, this is of 3 by 3 order. So, if I take transpose of A, then the rows become columns. First row become first column, second row become second column, and third row become third column. Then it is called transpose of A. So, in the case of symmetric matrix, if A transpose is equals to A, then this type of matrix is known as symmetric matrix. I can take an example here. Suppose I have 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 1. So, this is a matrix A. Suppose it is A equal to this. The order of this matrix is 3 cos 3. Now, I am taking transpose or transpose of A. So I can write it as first row become first column. So 1, 2, 3, next 2, 2, 1, then 3, 1, 3. So we can compare each element of these two matrices are equal. So we can say this matrix is a symmetric matrix. Similarly, I can define the skew symmetric matrix. In the case of skew symmetric matrix, the transpose of A must be equal to minus A. We can take example of skew symmetric matrix where the diagonal entry should be 0, here 1, minus 1, 2, minus 2, minus 3, 3. Suppose we have to take transpose of this matrix is equals to 0, 1, 2, minus 1, 0, minus 3, minus 2, 3, 0. Now, I have to multiply this A transpose by minus 1. So, I will get 0, this is plus 1, this is plus 2, this is minus 1, this is 0, this is minus 3, this is minus 2, 3 and 0. So, we can see the matrix A and the matrix minus of transpose A are same, we can see here. So, we can write A is equals to, or transpose of A is equals to minus of A, you can say this. So, this matrix is a skew symmetric matrix. Next, we have matrix operations. So, in matrix operation, we will learn about addition, subtraction, multiplication, adjoint, inverse and many operations related to inverse of a matrix. So, first of all, we have to learn how to add or subtract two matrices. So, here we are taking two matrices A and B. First of all, we have to calculate A plus B. Here we have A equal to this matrix and B, this is A matrix A, this is matrix B. So, we have to calculate A plus B. We can see A plus B is equals to, or we can take an simple example, we can take A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and B equal to minus 1, 1, 3, 0. Then A plus B is equals to, this is a 2 by 2 matrix, it is also 2 by 2 matrix. So, we can add first element to first element, this is 1, this is minus 1. So, we will get 1 minus 1 will be 0. Next 2 plus 1 will be 3, 3 plus 3 will be 6, 4 plus 0 will be 4. So, this is addition of two matrices. In similar way, we can add these two matrices. So, what will be the A plus B? Now, you can say easily. So, if I add 1, 0, 3 to 15, you will get 8, 1, 1, then 7, 3, 1, then 0, 5, 1, In similar way, we can add all other entries. So, we can see for addition or subtraction, the order of these two matrix have to be same. So, I have written here for subtraction or addition, the corresponding elements in two matrices of exactly the same size and shape. By size and shape, we mean that the number of rows and number of columns in matrix should be equal. So, we can add element wise addition or subtraction. So, we easily calculate the addition of these two matrices and subtraction as well as. Now, I am coming to multiplication. It is a very important and tricky operation. So, now we have to learn how to multiply two matrices. So, first of all, we have to take two matrix A and B. Suppose I have A matrix A11, A12, A13, here A21, A22, A23, then A31, A32, A33. This is a 3x3 matrix. Now, in second matrix B, I am taking B11, B12, B13, B21, B22, B23. Now, B31, B32, B33. So, we can see the order of these two matrix is same. So, first of all, we have to know about when two matrix are multiplicable or not. If the number of columns in matrix A, suppose I am taking here A matrix is of order m cross n and B is of order n cross p. So, now we have learned how to define, how to check what is the number of columns and what is the number of rows in a matrix. So, you can see easily how many rows in matrix A, there are m rows and n columns. In matrix B, there are n rows and p columns. So, if there are number of columns in matrix A is equals to number of rows in matrix B, then these two matrix can be multiplicable, otherwise not. So, firstly, we have to check if we want to multiply two matrices. Firstly, we have to check the number of columns in first matrix should be equals to number of rows in second matrix. These two are of same number. So, here I have take two matrix A and B, these two are square matrix. So, we can see the number of columns in matrix 1 is 3 and number of rows in matrix B is 3. So, we can multiply these two. So, now we can see what will be the multiplication of A and B. It is, so now we have to write A dot B is equals to. So, first of all, we have to take first row with first column, and then we will multiply first element of this row to first element of this column. So, we have A 1 1 into B 1 1. Then we have to multiply second element to second column, second element of first column, and we have to add these two elements B 2 1 plus then A 3 A 1 3 2 B 3 1 A 1 3 into B 3 1. In similar way, we will calculate second entry of this matrix, suppose it is C. So, we can write this expression in this summation form. Here, if I varies from 1 to 3 and j also varies from 1 to 3. So, you can see what will be the C 1 1 if I equal to 1, j equal to 1. So, you can write this summation will be of summation suppose will be of k. K is equals to 1 to 3. Suppose I is 1 here and j is 1. So, we can write C 1 1. What will be C 1 1? A 1 1 B 1 1 plus A 1 2 B 2 1 plus A 1 3 into B 3 1. So, this is like this first element of C matrix will be equal to this summation. So, we can write in the place of this, we can write here, we can write summation A I k B k j. Okay? Suppose we have to write all the entries in the summation form. So, we can write it is C 1 1, it is C 1 2, it is C 1 3, it is C 2 1, C 2 2, this is C 2 3, now this is C 3 1, C 3 2, C 3 3, where I can see, we can see what is C I j or what is C 1 1, what is C 1 2. Suppose I want to write C 1 2. So, we can use this summation notation here. Here I is equals to 1 and j is equals to 2. So, we can expand this in summation form. It will equal to summation A, summation A 1 A 1 k and B 2 no, it is B k 2. So, we are taking summation on k, k is equals to 1, 2, 3. So, we can write it as A 1 1 B 1 2 plus A 1 2 B22 plus A13B32. So, for calculating this element, we have to multiply first row with second column. So, you can see A11 into B12 plus A12 into B22 plus A13 into B32. So, in similar way, you can calculate all other entries of this matrix C. So, you can calculate C11, C12, C13, C21, C22, C23, C31, C32, then C33. Now, let us take an example for multiplication of two matrices. So, here we are taking two matrix A and B. So, we have to write C. C will be, now we can easily write the matrix C because we have learned earlier. So, firstly we have to multiply first row with first column of B matrix. So, 1 into 1, here we can calculate 1 into 1 plus minus 2 into 0 will be 0 plus 3 into 1 will be 3 is equals to 4. So, first entry of C will be 4. Now, we will multiply first row with second column. So, we can see 1 into 0 is 0 plus minus 2 into 2 is minus 2 plus 3 into 2 is 6. So, we will get 4. So, the second entry will be 4. Now, next we have to multiply first row with third column. So, we will get 2 plus minus 2 into 2 plus 3 into 0 will be 0 itself. So, it will be equal to 2 minus 4, that is minus 2. So, the third entry will be minus 2. In similar manner, we will start with second row. And first column, again you can calculate 2 into 1 is 2 plus 3 into 0 is 0 plus minus 1 into 1 is minus 1. So, what we will get? We will get 1, 2 minus 1 is 1. So, we will write here. Now, again we will multiply it with second column. So, we will get 0, 3 into 1, 3 minus 2 equal to 1. Similarly, now we will multiply with it. So, we can write 2 into, we have to erase this first. Now, so you can see 2 into 2 is 4. Plus 3 into 2 is 6 plus minus 1 into 0 is 0. So, it will be 10. You can write here 10. Now, in similar way, we have to multiply we have to multiply this third row with corresponding column. So we have firstly we have to multiply it. First column, so we will get minus 3 plus 0 plus 2, it is equals to minus 1. So, it is equals to minus of 1. Now, you have to multiply it with second column. So, we will get 0 plus 1 plus 4 is equals to 5. So, we have to write here. Now, the last entry of this matrix will be this. Minus 3 into 2 is equals to minus 6, this will be plus 2 plus 0 is equals to minus 4. So, we can write here. Now, we have matrix C of order 3 by 3. Suppose, we have two matrices. Suppose we have two matrices of order A is of order 2 by 3 and B is of order 3 by 6. Then you can see we can multiply these two matrices because the number of columns in matrix A is equals to number of rows in matrix B. So, the matrix C, the order of matrix C, can you tell me order of matrix C is what? Yeah, we can tell the matrix, the order of matrix C will be 2 cross 6. So, the number of rows in matrix C will be 2 and number of columns in matrix C will be 6. So, now we can easily multiply two matrices. Now, so I have to stop my lecture on multiplication of matrices. So, we have learned about various operations of matrices, types of matrices, and definition of matrix. So, I guess all of you understand all the basic concept of matrix. In next lecture, we will learn about how to calculate inverse of a matrix. So, for calculating inverse, we have to calculate adjoint of a matrix and determinant of a matrix. So, we will learn about all these operations in my next lecture. Thank you very much.